Greetings. Brother S., I will let your words speak for themselves. The only liar in this video is Texas 75023. This poor fellow is referring to a video titled Islam's Lies about Ishmael and Isaac. Crying liar is sadly an all too common behavior of those blinded by Islam. It actually makes me sad for this poor lad. Only God can free his heart and repair his mind. I dare to challenge you, Texas 75023. Why are you afraid to reply me in YouTube? Yes, he's shouting in all caps, and reading other posts, he knows he is shouting. This is the typical childishness of Mohammedan mental manipulation. They think insults can intimidate you into responding and submitting to their foolishness. But this child is about to demonstrate his inability to read and comprehend. The Bible, chapter 17, 16 through 20, explicitly says that Sarah will give birth to two sons. He did not say Genesis, but he should not need to, as we know where God spoke of Sarah. The Bible, chapter 17, 16 through 20, explicitly says that Sarah will give birth to two sons. I'm thinking he's trying to make an argument that Ishmael and Isaac are Sarah's sons. Yep, you heard and read that correctly. This Mohammedan claims two sons were promised. Explicitly says that Sarah will give birth to two sons. Remember rule number one, never, ever, ever believe what a Mohammedan says the Bible says. They are taught falsehoods, and they are conditioned to never, ever question or check what Islam tells them. Christians, please pray for this person and for all that might be set free from Satan's grip in Islam. Let us go read Genesis 17, 16 through 20, my fellow Bereans. I'm going to start at verse 15. Then God said to Abraham, as for Sarai, your wife, you shall not call her name Sarai, but Sarah shall be her name. This is where God changes her name. I will bless her, and indeed I will give you a son by her. Then I will bless her, and she will be a mother of nations. Kings of peoples will come from her. Well, here it says a son, meaning one son. Perhaps he is confused by this, a mother of nations. But would it make sense that Sarah herself would bear nations? Not to a rational, logical mind. Perhaps he is confused by this. Kings of peoples will come from her. That could imply more than one son, right? But Isaac was never a king. And since this says kings, plural, it must mean at least two other sons besides Isaac, the never-a-king son. Which would mean, if you thought this was literal, Sarah had at least three sons, and not only two. Either way, this does not say Sarah was promised two sons. Verse 17, then Abraham fell on his face and laughed, and said in his heart, will a child be born to a man 100 years old, and will Sarah, who is 90 years old, bear a child? A child, meaning one, not children. This is what Abraham understood. Still no mention or promise of two sons. Remember the claim that this person said after calling me a liar. The Bible, chapter 17, verse 16 through 20, explicitly says that Sarah will give birth to two sons. We're only to verse 17. Let us keep going reading the clear Bible. And Abraham said to God, oh, that Ishmael might live before you. Now this is the only verse Islam ever cares about, and we know Ishmael was already born, but not to Sarah, right? Ishmael was born to Hagar, the Tilth, not to Sarah. Explicitly says that Sarah will give birth to two sons. We're not finding that in verse 18 either. But God said, "No, but Sarah your wife will bear you a son, and you shall call his name Isaac, and I will establish my covenant with him for an everlasting covenant for his descendants after him." This is God speaking, and again says a son and not sons. God speaks a single name, his name Isaac, for the one son. God says with him, a singular pronoun, and not with them for sons. His descendants, another singular pronoun for a single promised son, not their descendants. As for Ishmael, I have heard you. Behold, I will bless him, and I will make him fruitful, and will multiply him exceedingly. He shall become the father of 12 princes, and I will make him a great nation. No mention here of Sarah having a second son after Isaac. Yes, this does mention Ishmael, who is already born, and not to Sarah. The God of Abraham respects Abraham's begging for Ishmael. We have just read Genesis 17, 15 through 20, and there is no mention of a second son from Sarah. You very clearly and boldly wrote, "The Bible chapter 17, 16 through 20 explicitly says that Sarah will give birth to two sons." We have just read this block of scripture together, brother. Your claim, Brother S., is wrong and provably false. Do you understand, Brother S., that your claim has been completely refuted? I'd like to ask you an honest question, brother. Can you see, brother, that the text does not say two sons were promised to Sarah? We have just read through it together, so that you may learn the truth. Are you an honest man, brother, that you desire to know the truth? Your religion teaches you to call me a liar, but the true religion of God teaches us to love our enemies, because we were all enemies of God at one time, but God showed his love for us even while we were sinners. This is the message of the Torah and the prophets, brother. If you had bothered to read the text, you could have sought and found the truth by yourself. Rather than even bothering to read, you have falsely accused me as a liar. You have broken one of God's 10 commandments, brother. Number 9, you shall not bear false witness. This is what Mohammed's religion has created in you, brother. Christians, I want you to learn from this exchange. It is with a person deceived by Islam, to the point he cannot read and think. Pray for him, please, and for all equally deceived by Satan's lies from Islam. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.